Hello everyone, in this video I will share how to use my SEO forecasting template that is built based on merging data from Google Analytics 4 and Google Search Console. So based on historical data from these two sources, you can forecast organic search traffic and conversions and revenue potential for such traffic on three levels. On the level of entire website, on the level of landing page, and on the level of the keyword. It consists of two pages. Yeah, the first one built around metrics, key events, and another for e-commerce metrics. So if you have properly implemented e-commerce tracking, you go to the second page and use only that. If you don't have that and implemented only key events conversion tracking, you use the first page. So I will use the first page because I don't have e-commerce tracking, and you may notice that I don't have event value and lost revenue metrics here because I don't send the revenue parameters when I send conversion events, so you don't see on this property, yeah, but if you set up it for yourself, when you will copy the template, you will see the values here. So we have three sections on this template. The first one, the section of the metrics for entire website. The first one are core metrics from Google Search Console, then core metrics from Google Analytics 4. And then these are custom metrics that I created based on the previous one. Yeah, and you can see the formula of this metrics. You can click here, yeah, and see what formula I use here to calculate the potential. Yeah. So, for example, if I set up the period for the last 120 days, this means that for this period I lost this amount of clicks and conversions because I don't rank number one for every keyword I rank my website ranks for. Yeah, so it's like the potential I have now. Then and the same on the tables by landing page and keyword. The blue values metrics from Search Console, yellow metrics from GA4, and red metrics are custom metrics that I calculate based on the previous one too. Yeah. What's the main idea? Yeah, of the template is that you will see the potential of your website, but the most important that you will be able to prioritize your landing pages and keywords based on the conversion and revenue potential. Yeah. So by default, I sort values here by lost key events. Yeah, so this means that I should try at first work on this landing page because this, like the amount of clicks I get and the conversion rate, all of that means that improving this landing page can get the biggest impact on my conversions and revenue. Yeah, so usually it means that I should update titles, update content, improving my internal, more internal and external backlinks, improving the design of the page, and so on and so on. Yeah, and the same for the keywords. About the custom metrics, yeah, a little bit how and why I decided to choose this specific formula to calculate them. So in the lost clicks, I multiply impressions on 0.2, it means that we assume that the CTR of the first position is 20%, which usually is a pessimistic assumption. Yeah, because like the stats shows that it's usually 30% CTR for the first position, but as more and more search queries get featured snippets from Google, get Google Ads and so on, I try to use a pessimistic forecast here. Yes. Yeah, so, when you will copy the template, you will be able to change it and like to set up like 0.25 or 0.30, and yeah, you can improve your make it more optimistic. Yeah. then it's like lost traffic, yeah. Then lost key events, so we just multiply the lost traffic of the landing page website on the key event rate, yeah, on the conversion rate, and using this formula we assume, we forecast how many conversions we don't get because we don't rank number one for all keywords. And the same for the revenue, we just multiply all previous, multiply lost conversions on the average event value of the conversion. Yeah, so what's important also to remember that I have here two different blending data sources, not only one. The first one is the data source that don't have query parameter. Yeah, I don't move query parameter here. The reason is because every time when you apply a query filter to the Google Search Console, you lose a lot of data by impressions and clicks, by so-called anonymous queries, yeah. And this means that you won't have the correct picture of how many clicks you got to your landing page and to your website, and it's also impact your overall forecasting, yeah. I will attach the text guide to this video, and in this text guide you can find the link to the Google Search Console help and the screenshot with the explanation why this happens. And if we don't use the query parameter here, this means that we can't use a filter by search query, yeah, because it won't apply to this to these charts. And then another table, yeah, with the queries, this is another blended data source. Here I use a query parameter, and because without that we won't see the any metrics for keywords. Yeah, and important that how do I forecast the conversions and revenue for keywords? We just assume that every keyword will get the same amount of conversions and revenue as it will have the same conversion rate as the landing page by which ranked by this keyword has. Yeah. So if my overall, for example, Google Search Console, let's see, Google Search Console landing page for Google Studio template has a conversion rate 0.23. This means that I apply this conversion rate to Rank Tracker template keyword 2. Yes, and based on that, I calculate how many lost key events I have here. So, yeah, and another important thing that about editing our data blending, we should use here the custom dimension for landing page, because by default GA4 does not have the same landing page dimension as GSC has. So that's why I create the custom formula that we merge the values that helps to reproduce the same URL. And this is important to know that if your website, sometimes you may need to update this formula to make your report working, because if your website doesn't have the slash at the end of URL, you may need to exclude this symbols from the formula, yeah, because without that you will have different URLs in Search Console and GA4. Okay, so that's all, yeah, about the copying the template after the buy. You can click make a copy, and you'll be able, you should use two dimensions. Here you will must to set up the Search Console URL dataset, and here the GA4 default property we will use here too. So that's all. If you have any questions, write them in the comments, and see you soon.